Hi students, I think all of you are very well. So during this lockdown period, and hopefully we are coming to the new world very soon. So that till then, we are going to learn with the help of this online classes. As I told it earlier that we have to learn first object and class. So it comes to here, object-oriented programming languages. Whenever we are coming object-oriented programming languages, it consists of two things. One is we called as in class, and one is we called an object. As I have written over there, this is we called class, this is we call object. Now comes to here, suppose as I told it over there, COVID is a class, or might be we can say like that, say book is a class, it is a class, right? So it consists of some of the characteristics. What are the characteristics? Like characteristics, the number of pages, then the who is the author of this one. So we are telling the author. Next we are coming the price, and then we are coming the publisher. So these are the characteristics of a book. Now your Java book written by some other, any other book also written by some other, so they are the object of the class book. So a specific book, suppose if you go for the Java, this book possesses all of these characteristics, as well as they are consist of the some of the programs. So this is we called as an object, and this is belongs to the class. So according to the definition, we can say object and class. Class is a certain entity which possesses some of the characteristics. An object is an instance of a class. I once again repeat, class are possessing some of the common characteristics. It's an entity basically which contains the common characteristics, and this object is nothing but the instance of a class. Now these object-oriented programming languages, as I told it earlier, we have some common phenomena. First of all, whatever we are coming, like data abstraction. What is data abstraction? Suppose you are right now everyone using mobile phones. Now mobile phones, whenever you're making a phone call, might be the WhatsApp, might be checking your Facebook account, anything. Do you are interested how does it the working in background going on? You just simply open your Facebook app or any other WhatsApp app, and then you do the work whatever you look on. So data abstraction is nothing but it says you execute the system without knowing the background details. Once again, data abstraction is says it execute the system without knowing the background details. You're traveling through car right now, that's not possible because of the, but hopefully from the next week we are going on. So over there, whatever we are getting, that we are driving a car or you are going through a car without knowing how does car work inside. So similarly, this is we call data abstraction. Next is coming data encapsulation. Encapsulation, what is this? Encapsulation means wrapping up. Suppose you have a mobile phones and you have a SIM card. If you carry your mobile phones and the SIM card separately and you say yes, I have a mobile phone, then there is no utility of the mobile phone. Until or unless you place the SIM card in case of within the mobile phone, then you can say that your mobile phone is active and you may call, you can go for the internet activities, etc., etc. So similarly, whenever you are purchasing a computer, you are getting the all the components of it, and until or unless you assemble together, you cannot say it's a complete system. So this is also like that. Even if you are going to give some gift to your friends, what we do, we are giving the wrapper paper, wrapping up with the gift paper, and then give it to the friend. So similarly, here is also like that. Data encapsulation means wrapping up of data and method into a single unit. That is we call data encapsulation. Next, we are coming to the point that is polymorphism. Polymorphism. What is this? Poly means many. Morph means form. Many form. As I told it over there, here you are basically at home, you are a good child. In school, you are a good student. In neighbors, you are a good neighbor. As well as in friends, you are a good friend. So you are alone one, but play the different roles in different cases. This is we call polymorphism. One function or one components we are using for the different purposes. They have a common name but serve different purpose. This is we call polymorphism. Next in the characteristics, whatever we have, that is we call inheritance. Inheritance, what it says? Inheritance says inheritance says that one characteristics of a parent are inherited to the child. Similarly, suppose your father is a great writer, mother is a great singer. So by default, you are inherited the characteristics from parents, as well as you are able to do good pictures. You can draw over there. You can paint very nice painting. So this is the way that characteristics of one class is inherited to the other class. This is we call inheritance. And the last one we are coming, that is we call modularity. Now modularity means as we doing the work at home, at morning you are learning English, afternoon you are learning history, geography, after taking your lunch you are going for mathematics, then computer applications programs. And then evening you are going for some entertainment from the computer, gaming, etc., etc. And evening also you are writing some questionnaires and then go for the sleep. So what happens, you basically divide the work into some segments. These segments we called as an modules. Like this work you have to do right now, after that another sort of work, after that another sort of work. This is we call modules. This modular concept says that you divide the entire day into some modules, and the entire process we call as an modularity. So this is the concept of OOPS languages, and we are getting the concept of Java class and object. Now we are coming to the segment, as I told it earlier, like in class 8 we have a Java components. So as you know, the Java is a very important language for nowadays, and it has some its own characteristics also. It is given in the books also that Java is a very much case sensitive. Okay, before going to Java, this process, let me write one very simple program for you so that we can understand, right? So this is very simple program, but I have written so many things. First of all, Java is very much case sensitive. You already got it. I have written all these in a small letter. Only the class name I have given the capital letters. It's not a mandatory that you have to give the class name as in capital letters. You can give any of the combination. But whenever you are writing the first keyword, which is called class, this is the difference between the basic and the Java. in basic whatever the programs you have done, that is not a matter. You can go for any kind of activities, and there is no consistency in basic. But in Java, you have to very much take care of this kind of activities. This is the class. Then this is my class name. This name is my class name. Then we have to write it public, static, void, main. What are the IL components? I'll give it later on, no question about it. Then string, args, we have to write it. There are so many processes we can go for, but according to the councils, we have to go on like this. Then this is the starting of the program by indicating our curly braces or the second bracket, whatever we are saying. Then this is the called data type. Means the what type of value you are going to do. Is it integer? Integer means like a whole number. This is we call integer. Now here these are called tokens. All of you know that tokens. I have given the printout of this one. Tokens means the variables, constants. Variables, constants. These are all also tokens. Token is a small unit of a Java program, which consists of the various things like this variable, constants, and other also so many things we are going to be learned. So this is are called variables. And here this is we as we know this is called constants. Now what happens? I have declared three variables x, y, and z. Now after that, we are assigning the 100 to x, 200 to y, and then add them, which is coming to the result also to z. And then whatever we have to go for, we are writing system, S in capital letters, system dot dot out dot print. Then within the quotes, we are giving the message sum is. And then we are writing the variable called z to print the value of the summation. And finally, we are getting here is opening of the braces, here is closing of the braces. Here is opening of the braces, here is closing of the braces. So these are the braces is very important as it is go for a complete program. So this is one sample programs of Java 1. And next video, I am coming to the segments of how does Java program compilation takes place. Till then, thank you and keep watch. I'll upload the video as soon as possible. Thank you. Stay home, stay safe.